alive with you, purge the soul. Make love your goal.
The power of love, a force from above, cleansing my soul.
We are gathered here today in the sight of love. Today we marry ourselves. We have been through some times, but we have survived, and we look pretty damn good doing it. No one knows how to throw a party like a gay party. And we're all here tonight. The L's, the G's, the B's, the T's, the Q's, the I's, the A's, the P2S. Everybody here together is family. We are family. And we stand on the shoulders of those who have fought for us. And here we stand, 10 years on. We won again and again and again, honey. We won the fight to decriminalize same-sex relationships. We won the fight for equal age of consent. We won the right to get HIV meds into our queer body. We won the right to legally change our gender. We fought and we won adoption rights for legal protection in the eyes of the law. We won the right to get PrEP on the NHS. When we fight together, babies, we always win. Say it with me. We will always win. We will always win. We will always win. We will always win. Why? Because we're gay. It's what we do. We will toast our victories today. I see some of you have a little tinny with you. I, of course, am alcohol free, but I toast you with my blood, with my heart, with my soul. I pay tribute to you. And we salute those across the world who are still fighting for even the first one of our rights that we have won. And we stand with them. We see you. We love you. We are you. But don't get complacent. We all know, we can see there is a tsunami of hate that is coming towards us. Some would say from the top of our own government. But we will win. Say it, we will win. We will what? We will work. Yes, indeed. So, as we celebrate tonight our beauty, our strength, remember, you are not alone. There are millions, even billions of us in this world, and this world belongs to us. This world, whether they like it or not, is queer as fuck, baby. So, here we are, ready to marry ourselves. It's time to bring the side of yourself that has always doubted yourself and put it in the arms of the true self that knows that you are beautiful, that you were born beautiful, you will live as a beauty, and when you eventually pass on, you will pass on as a beauty. That there is no one like you in the world. Every one of us is essential. The world would be incomplete without you. We need you happy. We need you in love with yourselves. Because love will win. Say it with me. Say it louder. One more time, folks. So, here we are together. And if anybody has reason to believe that we should not proceed with this ceremony of love, speak now or forever hold your peace.
Okay, Ricky. Yo. Wait.
Who the hell is
you
she?
You guys, hold up. Hush up. Yeah. I have something to say. Sorry to interrupt. You were on a roll.
I was.
But I'm going to say something now.
Well, looking that fierce, you deserve to say something.
Well, hello, everybody. Yeah. I was married once to a straight cis guy, and it was the biggest mistake of my life. But I was a suicidal depressive, so maybe I thought that was the better of two evils. Who knows? But when I left him and finally realized I was gay because I had sex with a woman, yes, indeed, it was all shout hallelujah. Come on, get happy. Cause she's waiting to take your hand. Forget your troubles. Come on, get happy. Cause we're headed for the promised land. And yes, 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 it was the sex. Who knew? It was dazzling, as if I'd been asleep my whole life and only just discovered the sun. And yes, I wanted to sing hallelujah, not just for me, for all of us, for the joys of being ourselves, being who we are. I told my grandmother, even though I don't believe in life after death, I told her that she didn't have to worry about me anymore. That I was going to be all right. Life, just being alive, being the real me, the real lesbian me, was going to be all right. And that was one of the best days. Yes, sisters, rave that hand. Yes. Probably the best day of my life. And then years later, on another day, I was sitting outside home with some of my mates, and we were playing Jenga and drinking cocktails and having a good time, just being ourselves, living our best life. And a gay white guy sitting next to us in the miraculous sunshine asked, what was the special occasion? And I said, oh, just some older black lesbians, you know, and mates getting together. And he said, and He laughed while he said it. I didn't know that existed. And just like that, negated our world, erased our lives, just like that. But here tonight, while we all we queerly beloved, are here gathered together, I want you to remember, we can't be careless about each other like that. We have to fight for our right to be joyous together. We have to support each other. Because like Ricky mentioned, you can hear that even though I've lived in Manchester most of my life, I wasn't born here, I was born in the States. And back in the States, in the US, in Tennessee, they want to ban drag. The judges stopped them, but they wanted to do it. And in 14 other states, they're still trying. In Florida, they've banned gender-affirming medical care for under 18s, and they want to ban it for over 18s, too. While schools have been told, don't say gay. Does that sound familiar? Yeah, we beat Clause 28, but it's coming back across the pond. Bad shit is drifting across the Atlantic. They've attacked Drag Queen Storytime in London and Edinburgh. They attacked Clone Zone right across the street 4 times in the last few months. And here, right here, the government is blocking Scottish gender reforms to make it easier so that our trans siblings can be legally recognized as their true selves. And Labour, that's right, I would boo that shit. And Labour joined in, backtracking on their promises for self-ID. They haven't learned anything from history. Pandering to bigots is never a good look. And in this country, right here, puberty blockers are restricted to research only. So if you're young and trans, you have to know how to get yourself onto a research protocol to get that life-saving, mind-saving treatment. How many of you know how to do that? Get research to get the medicine you need. Think you would have known how to do that when you were a teenager? I know I wouldn't. There have been over 141 protests and attacks on drag queen story time in the States in 2022, dozens and counting this year, including trying to burn down a church. And in California, a man shot and killed a woman for displaying a pride flag. Just think about what this weekend has been like for us, and think about that. Our folks and their families and friends have to ask themselves if it's safe to fly our many flags. And if you think that kind of knuckle-dragging viciousness couldn't come here, remember those protests at Tate Britain, London, Edinburgh, more against reading stories to children so that they know it's okay to be us. 2 men stabbed outside the 2 Brewers in Clapham just the other week for being gay. 2 more stabbed in Brixton just last week. The promised land? Not exactly, not yet. And that's why I had to speak up. But there is hope, all my queerly beloved. Yeah, there is, absolutely. We are the hope. We who are here tonight. Manchester, I want to introduce you to some people. Come on, folks, come on stage. Yes, make more noise for my black lesbian friends. Thank you so much, because we will stand together. There is hope. We have got to get better at raising each other up, not cutting each other down. We are here. We have always been here. That's why I'm standing here with my black lesbian friends, because I believe we will get there. Yes, like Ricky said, love will always win. but only because we know how to kick ass together.
One, two, one, two. Sound, could we have some keys, please? As around the sunny earth, no, she's revolving. And the rosebuds know to bloom in early May. Just as hate knows love's the cure, you can rest your mind assured that I'll be loving you always. Now, can't we feel the mystery of tomorrow? But in passing, we'll go older every day. Just as all that's born is new, you know what I say is true, that I'll be loving you always until the rainbow burns the stars out of the sky.
Always.
Until the ocean covers every mountain high.
Always.
Until the moon is flying parents.
Yeah.
Her acceptance is the way we play.
Did you know that life is giving love a guarantee to last forever and another day?
As the day I know I'm living but tomorrow, give me the past that I mustn't fear. We can't fear, cause I know deep in my mind the love of me I left behind. And
the stars out of the sky.
Always.
The ocean covers every mountain high.
I said always.
Until the dolphins fly in Paris to the sea.
Always.
The life becomes a dream.
Now ain't that love in you?
Until the day is night and night becomes a day.
I said ain't that love in you?
Until the chances teach yourself and fly away.
Did you know that true love asks for nothing? Her acceptance is the way we pay.
Did you know that life is giving love a guarantee to last forever, another day?
Me the past that I mustn't fear.
Now I know deep in my mind the love of me I left behind, and I'll be loving you always.
Up to the rainbow, face the stars out of the sky.
Always.
The ocean covers every mountain high.
I said always.
Up to the darkest flying parents live at sea.
Yeah.
Big love, all of you. Shouts to Cheryl and shouts to the amazing band and yourselves as well. Blessings.
Hello, hello, how are we doing? How are we doing? happy Pride. It's the last day of Pride, it's the vigil. And I'm Bolly Bubbles. I'm here to read you a poem that I wrote about this skirt that I'm wearing. I like making stuff. I bought this from Primark. It was a bit long, and I thought, shorter. And then I wore it out, and then I thought, shorter, actually. Make it a bit shorter. I'm going to read a poem from my phone, because it's, as I said, the last day of Pride, and I'm tired, and I can't remember stuff. Monday today, is it? I woke up 4 hours ago, I can't really remember. I am not checking Grindr, I promise. I'm not right now. Maybe in 10 minutes, I don't know. It's very busy, Jesus. And the poem I'm reading today is about desire and danger. Being a queer person with a masculine body, it's...
you, because I think sometimes we see all those anti-trans headlines and I read them and they kind of impact me. And I think, imagine having to read those headlines and then go into school. Imagine what that's like. And I just wanted you to kind of share some of your experience of the school years, which haven't been all that easy, have they?
Of course, yeah. So my school experience wasn't the best. I was one of the first people to come out as queer. I was clearly very masculine and it was very difficult for me. I was hate crimed, I've been insulted, called names, and my school wasn't exactly the best dealing with it. They are improving, but there still needs to be so much more. They need to not tolerate it. There's so much hate out there. And
it kind of came from the top as well, from the kids, your peers. It was also coming from above, wasn't it, as well?
Yeah.
So we're not going to mention that.
No.
For legal reasons.
Yes.
So is there anything you would like to say to the young kind of trans people out there?
Yes. Don't let anyone's expectations define who you are. You can present and be who you are, and don't let anyone fucking tell you otherwise, okay? Be whatever you want to be.
I just wish I'd known you at school. We'd have had a lot of fun.
We would.
So,
we would.
And as we have our community here en masse, is there anything you can let us know of something we should be doing a bit better as a community for you?
Schools, the education system, you just need to listen to your students, your trans students, your queer students, because they're struggling. It's not all perfect. No, everyone's happy. Everyone's getting bullied. There's kids dying, you know? People are suffering and they're just not doing anything. They're not listening. So please, staff, just provide a safe space for your students, please.
Thank you, Wednesday. So I thought, without further ado, as Wednesday's come up here and shared that with us, I thought we should do a minute's applause, sending that energy across this gathering here, out into Manchester, to support all our trans and queer youth today. Let's raise them up. Let's support them. Are you ready to clap for a whole minute? On your marks. Get set. Go! Yes! Keep going. Nobody's remembered to time this. Keep going. That's for you. That's for you. It's for Wednesday. You're amazing. You're amazing. And just remember, T-shirts are available at transcreative.uk, just saying. Thank you, Wednesday. I love you.
Ode to the Tea Boys, after Wendy Cope. To the share tips like orange carpels, boys. To the makes being trans in this hellscape less hell, boys. To the weight lift and eat more, boys. To the ignore my nips, can you help me with this tape, boys. To the I got top surgery. Anyone want a free binder, boys? To the mesh vests and queer clubs, boys. To the makes barbers confused, boys. To the silver carabiner on belt loops, boys. To the we'll start our own sports clubs, boys. To the apply minoxidil when you brush your teeth, boys. To the always hungry no matter what they eat, boys. To the picnic in the park meets, boys. To the this was my doctor, cost and surgery experience, boys. To the sweats it out on chest day instead, boys. To the wears makeup and loves being pretty, boys. To the mascara only on their mustache, boys. To the lonelier now they pass, boys. To the spread tester gel with its lid, life hack, boys. To the which GPs take us seriously, boys. To the do you mind donating to my GoFundMe, boys. To the reluctant to make their own GoFundMe, boys. to the yet-to-start tea boys, to the on-year-long waitlist boys, to the boys who aren't out as boys, boys, to the boys assaulted on the streets, boys, to the boys who are grieving family, boys, to the takes life on the fuzzy chin, boys, to the makes me believe this life can be great, boys, to the land's fists on transphobic pricks, boys, to the boys, I love you. I'm glad we exist, boys.
The theme of my speech tonight comes from an ACT UP slogan, earn your attitude. I know there are three things, and only three things, that produce change in the world: education, art, and activism. The image you see here does all three. In Nazi-era Germany, as Jewish and antisocial, which is how lesbians and activists were designated, I would have been forced to wear a yellow star and a black triangle. Gay men and trans women were made to wear pink triangles pointing downwards. Early in the AIDS crisis, the activist artist group Grand Fury, my comrades, designed the image you see behind me, silence equals death, with a triangle pointing up. I told you there were three things that can change the world. Well, here are the three things that make change impossible: ignorance, complacency, and silence. Just as art is not a luxury, but a necessity, especially for queers, so should education not be a privilege, but an obligation. We must educate each other and ourselves. Complacency says, well, everything is all right with the world because they're all right with me. Or maybe they're not exactly all right with me, but what can I do? Silence in the face of injustice is complicity. The antidote to silence is action. Do you ever wonder what you would have done during the Nazi pogroms, or before and after Stonewall, when dykes and fags and trans folks had to decide whether to join the fight for liberation or sit quietly by? Or during the emergency years of the AIDS crisis, when governments did not just abandon us, but punished us and let us die for who we were and who we loved? Have you longed to be alive at the right time so you could be part of history? Well, welcome to history. It is happening now. One of the crises we are living through right now is a mental health crisis. Depression, anxiety, perfectionism, the defeat of not even being able to try to help others, because what difference does it make? I am here to tell you, first of all, that it is not your fault. Open your eyes and look beyond your anguish to the system that creates and benefits from your solitary pain. And second of all, that the answer to these problems is care, community, friendship. These are our queer superpowers. Actual mental health support, of course. And one profound thing that no one ever tells you: activism. Making change. Finding your power and agency to change the world around you. I swear to you, I promise you, it is the cure. Activism is the most selfish thing I have ever done. It saved my life in more ways than I can possibly tell you. I know that the theme for tonight is battles we have fought and won, but we have to remember also the battles we have lost. We always must remember and honor our defeats. On the road from gay shame to queer joy, let us please stop and feel that pain and turn that pain into action. One way of honoring loss is, yes, through silence. We will have that during our vigil, and I respect and cherish that. But before we get there, I want us to speak, to remember, to shatter silence. The thing that I am most moved by in AIDS memorials is the naming of the dead. I have lost many friends, many comrades, and it is tempting to take my moment on the stage with a microphone and name them all now. Instead, I want us all to take a few moments to name not the people we have lost, but to name the comrades we love, our chosen friends and family who exist, who are alive, the people without whom we would be less than ourselves. The worst years of the AIDS crisis were about losing precisely those people who were not recognized as our kin, our queer community. Let us acknowledge them now, a roll call of the people we would fight for. Call out their first and last names now. For the sake of those people you have just named, and for yourselves, for your own selfish survival, I want you to make a promise to me tonight. In the next month, commit one act of bravery. Speak up to defend someone or against an injustice, even if you are nervous or scared. Especially if you are nervous or scared. And share it. Tag me on Twitter. Hashtag queer commitment. You do not need to protest in large groups or get arrested to make a difference. But you do need to do something. Fight for yourself and the people you love now. Save your life and their lives now. Don't wait to commemorate them. Honor them now. What will you do in the next month and months to come to honor your queer commitment? I am a veteran of ACT UP, the AIDS Coalition to Unleash Power. Let me show you what solidarity feels like, what action over silence feels like. Join me now in the legendary ACT UP chant. I will say it first, and then we will say it together three times with fists raised. ACT UP! Fight back! Fight AIDS! 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 You are all, for now, honorary members of ACT UP. But remember, keep it going. Honor the queer commitment we have made here together tonight. Earn your attitude. In solidarity, I thank you very much.
It's not the end, it's just the beginning of another path. And life is full of that. You can have a lot of support. And yes, there's a lot of people living with HIV, full lives.
It's not a barrier to living your life in any way, shape, or form you want. Your life's not over. It's not a death sentence anymore. It's not the end. In some respects, it's actually the beginning. I'm quite glad I'm HIV positive. You know, I don't have any shame about it. And I think, in some respects, it's given me a life. Having HIV and the experience I've gone through has given me so much more than if I hadn't have got HIV, if that makes sense.
Come to George House Trust. As an act of self-love, come to George House Trust and let us show you, and let us make a difference. Let us show you what is possible.
Try not to worry. And I'm living proof that, you know, you can have a life. A life with regrets is no life at all. So if you feel like doing something, you go and bloody do it.
It might be a bumpy emotional ride. It might not be, it might be just dead easy. It's gonna be different depending on who they are. Everyone's got their own journey. Everyone's got their own experience. But ultimately, yeah, it's gonna be fine. It's gonna be all right.
Come to George House Trust. They'll look after you.
this song will not be in a minor key. That is not how it goes. This song is not a song of pain or misery. We've had enough of those. This song will not be sad or sentimental. We all have broken hearts. This song will not be in a minor key. And this is how it starts.
Nothing compares to you. Iridescent rhinestones meet the hand-stitched lettering of a lover's name. To love another is to choose creation while you push through pain. It was a labor of love. It was a labor of grief, a way of weaving in the memories of lives too brief. Objects hold on to memories like half-forgotten dreams. They wait dormant in the threads that hold the seams. What is a community if not a patchwork quilt made by hand? A way of shouting out our stories from the witness stand. Those silent, stolen stories of our elders and our youth will keep retelling, keep honoring, keep reclaiming the truth. It's in the satin of red ribbons, the signatures of friends. It's in the dates that mark beginnings and the dates that mark ends. It's the fabric that holds history and stories untold. It's silk, chiffon, embroidery, and scraps of gold, all those voices woven together side by side. Amongst the loss, I see the bindings of pride. I see dedication of hands to ordinary people's lives. How in something intentional and tactile, love thrives. We now invite you to light your candles. And as we flood this space with light, please share the flame around and take a breath as we hold silence for 1 minute to remember those who came before us.
I have come out 3 times in my life. Once as a gay man, second time as a trans woman. Both times accepted and loved by the people that matter. You see, I grew up against a backdrop of the AIDS crisis and Section 28. Which our wonderful government put in place and just taught me as a young gay kid that there was stigma. But now, here, in Manchester, I feel safe and I feel loved. So I'm going to come out for the third and final time. My name is Alexa Vox. I am a trans woman and I am HIV positive, undetectable. I am very much alive. Someone to hurt me too deep. Someone to sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alive, being alive. Somebody need me too much, and somebody know me too well. Somebody pull me up short and put me through hell and give me support for being alive, being alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Fuck me.
Hello. Hey, hello, Manchester Pride. Oh, you gotta be excited more than that. Manchester Pride. It's so good to be here this evening to celebrate all of who we are. My name is Jide Macaulay. My pronouns are he, him, and Mama Jide. And if you forget my name, just remember the happy, holy, homosexual. You weren't expecting a priest tonight, were you? No, there's always surprises along here. But tonight we can always acknowledge the fact that we celebrate Alexa this evening. We celebrate their courage. We celebrate all that they brought to us just a few moments ago. 20 years ago, I found myself at a place of diagnosis of HIV. It was a troubled time for me. I struggled, I thought I was going to die. But today, I stand before you, a happy, holy, healthy homosexual. I want to reassure you that testing for HIV is very important. Encourage and support each other and your friends. For me personally, being black and gay and a Christian, I'm living well with HIV. And I'm sure you've heard the phrase, you know, you equals you. I am undetectable. And that means that I cannot pass it on. Right. There were times that I struggled being black and gay. I struggled being a gay man and a Christian. So being black, gay, and a Christian and living with HIV felt like a struggle. But I want to reassure you tonight, the struggle is over. The struggle is truly over because, you know, living well with HIV is part of that journey that we see. It is important that we must talk about HIV. There is still a high prevalence of HIV infection around the world, and particularly in our cities. It is important that we find the right support for each other. It is time that we break the barrier of stigma, shame, denial, and discrimination. Can we do this together? We can. It is important to create safe spaces, to have space for peer support. And I'm so proud that when I moved to Manchester over a year ago, I became part of the family of George House Trust. Come on now, let's give it up for George House Trust. George House Trust creates safe spaces for people living with HIV. George House Trust provides peer support. And I also became one of the HIV mentors to provide support to other people. It's important to have access to medication and healthcare. And of course, in the city of Manchester, we should be so proud that 95% of people living with HIV have been tested. 99% of those tested are on medication. 97% are undetectable. And 90% are enjoying a great quality of life. Come on now. So just imagine when I was diagnosed in 2003, let's compare that to today. Things have changed. We cannot pass it on. That's a great message. We need to support one another, but we also must remember that the reality is not left over here in Manchester. It's beyond Manchester. Our friends in Uganda, in Ghana, and in Nigeria are persecuted. They're discriminated against. Recently, a law was passed in Uganda where if you are a gay man with HIV, it's called aggravated homosexuality, and you will be sentenced to life, imprisonment, or in some cases, the death sentence. So tonight, I want us to remember those far away that are struggling with being who they are. There'll be a QR code, I believe it's on the screen. Please scan it and send a petition to the UK government to sanction those homophobic politicians and religious leaders. As a priest myself, it is important that we hear positive messages from our religious leaders. And I'm very proud that the Diocese of Manchester recognized my ministry, particularly within the LGBT community and on HIV. So we need to challenge our religious leaders to speak well, to understand our journey and be there to support us. Finally, my friends, we stand before you. I stand before you today because you equals you, because we cannot pass it on, and we have the ability to achieve zero HIV stigma in our society. And I conclude, and I want to invite you to chant with me, respect my HIV, respect. Respect my HIV. Respect my HIV. Respect my HIV. Respect my HIV. Thank you so much.
Looking
This is a love story. They say life is short. Don't let it feel long. Live, live, live. As we said, the tsunami is coming, but we have no fear of storms, for we have learned to sail our ships, our queer ships. Remember, this is your life. You deserve to live it to the full, as free as the moment you were conceived, as brave as the moment you decided to be born. We are your family. You are our family. And as you walk home tonight, remember, you are not alone. This is a love story. Love yourself, love each other, and they will never, 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 never win. Are you ready to say it? I love myself. I love myself. I love my life. This world is mine. And this world is gay. Thank you for being part of this beautiful love story. Give yourselves your round of applause.
So make love your goal. Make this your goal. Cleansing my soul.
So in love with you, love's a soul.